Hello grade 12. So in the previous lecture we discussed about DNA fingerprinting and their steps. I told you in the previous lecture what is DNA fingerprinting. In DNA fingerprinting we basically take a sample of the DNA to identify any individual. Okay, and after that we discuss the various steps which is used for the DNA fingerprinting. Okay, so today we will discuss about the uses of DNA fingerprinting, where DNA fingerprinting technique is used. Okay, so first, DNA fingerprinting is basically used to diagnose the inherited disorders. Okay, so basically DNA fingerprinting basically help to diagnose the disorder which is present in both prenatal and the newborn babies. Which type of disorder? Disorders may include cystic fibrosis, hemophilia, Huntington disease, familial Alzheimer's, sickle cell anemia, thalassemia, and there are so many diseases that we can find with the help of DNA fingerprinting. Okay, so after that, DNA fingerprinting is also used to solve the crime. How? See, the pattern of the DNA profile. Firstly, we have to take the DNA pattern, DNA sample, then we will make a pattern. So, in that pattern, we will compare that DNA profile with those of the victim and the suspect. After that, if the profile matches the suspect, it provides strong evidence that the suspect was present at the crime scene. Chicken? If the profile does not match the suspect, then that suspect may be eliminated from the inquiry. For example, a violent murder occurred. So the forensic team retrieved a blood sample from the crime scene. And after the taking the sample, they prepared DNA profile of that blood sample. The victim and the suspect as follows. Okay, so firstly, they have to prepare a pattern. Okay, the pattern from the blood sample which they have taken from crime scene. Second, pattern of the suspect. Third, pattern of the victim. Okay, after that, they will find. So, in this slide, first is the suspect profile in which DNA pattern is there. Second is blood sample from the crime scene. Third is the victim profile. So here we will match the DNA pattern of the suspect profile and victim profile to blood sample. So whose profile will match more? That means that is the criminals. Okay. So after that, DNA fingerprinting is also helping solving medical problems. So DNA profile can be used to determine whether a particular person is the parent of a child. Okay, so the child's paternity, that means father, or a maternity, that means mother, can be determined. So this type of information can be used in first paternity suits, second inheritance cases, third one is the immigration cases. Okay. So how we can find that, I will tell you in the next slide. So see, in this slide, a paternity test is there. So what you have to do? Firstly, you have to make the pattern. So by comparing the DNA profile of mother and her child. So identify DNA fragment in the child which are absent from the mother, that must be present or inherited from the biological father. So here, first DNA pattern is of mother, second is of child, third one is of that unknown man. Okay, so here we will match the DNA pattern from man and the mother. So if that pattern is not matching with mother, that must be matching from their biological father. Okay, so one band from the father, or maybe second from the mother. So we can conclude that the man is the biological father. So we can use DNA fingerprinting in other field also. For example, personal identification. The US Armed Service are just beginning a program where they collect DNA fingerprinting from all personnel for later use. In case they need to identify casualty or missing people. Okay. After that, the use of DNA fingerprinting. Some other uses of DNA fingerprinting. First one is the identification of the carcasses of the tissue. Second, we can detect the somatic mutation or the cancer. Third, we can also detect pathogen identification. Detection of the loci controlling quantitative traits or disease resistance. Next, DNA fingerprinting is also used for the sex determination. And DNA fingerprinting is also used to identify any individual. So there are some famous cases in which DNA fingerprinting is used. So in 2002, Elizabeth Hurley used DNA fingerprinting to prove that Steve Bean was the father of her child, Damien. Okay, so second popular case is there, Colin Pitchfork. That was the first criminal that caught based on the DNA fingerprinting evidence. So he was arrested in 1986 for the rape and the murder of two girls and was sentenced in 1988. Okay, so you have seen how we can use DNA fingerprinting in different field. Okay, so the rest part we will discuss in the next lecture. Till then,